everybody. Welcome to the stream for the afternoon. I'm here with lead designer Paul Boyer for Galciv 3. Hey, Paul.
Hello.
So what are we talking about today, Paul?
I think we're mostly just going to talk about the 1.7 patch that came out. Well, it came out in opt-in about an hour ago.
Awesome.
And some of the new features, some that are hopefully much requested feature or issues we've addressed, but and see how people like them. Sorry.
No, you're fine.
So the one thing I was just playing around with is the new Starbase system, which is probably the biggest, mm-hmm. you know, most requested issue we have is micromanagement of Starbases.
Right. We've talked a little bit about that before.
Yeah. And so what we finally did is something that we have been actually wanting to do since right before 1.0, but we never actually got around to it because there was other issues. As we switch this to now, okay, so if I select the Starbases now, you'll see that they have a line connecting them to this shipyard. And to whatever their sponsor shipyard is. So essentially now mm-hmm. they're kind of like a Starbase. So a shipyard is sponsored by a planet.
Right.
Starbases are sponsored by shipyards. However, they can be sponsored by multiple shipyards. So by default, every shipyard you build will get put into this queue. But if you were like, oh, I don't want it requesting stuff from the other side of the galaxy, you can go in here and change it. You can also change what type of... So this is similar to what we had before with the request constructor. When you go in here, I'm going to say...
Paul, I'm going to cut you off for just a second because apparently we're not even streaming.
Okay, that's fine.
It's not even showing up.
That is...
Oh, wait. Someone's saying it's working. Half of them are saying they can't. Right,
typical.
Then. Just a second, guys. This is definitely a Twitch thing, not on our end.
Oh, man.
Give us just a moment, and then we'll let Paul launch back into his
little spiel
explanation. Right. Sorry, Paul,
so
to cut you off.
Where is my support Durantium? Let's get over here.
All right. Some of them are trying refreshing, so we can just kind of actually come to think of it. Let me try doing the same because I'm not seeing picture come up to begin with. Let's see. Oh, there we are. All right. All right. Refresh seems to have done the trick. So carry on, Paul.
All right. So I don't know where we were, so I'm just going to pretty much start over.
All right.
So now, now as we get... actually, wait, so let me send this guy. Oh, man, I don't know. These are both extreme. Let's see what's over here. I hate to explore with a colony ship. But all right. So... The way it works now is, well, that's the new ship list. We can talk about that in a bit. Is Starbases are now sponsored by shipyards. By default, they will actually add every shipyard to their sponsor list, unlike a planet, mm-hmm. Unlike a shipyard. So it'll add them all to this list. But if you are a hardcore player and you want to manually say, no, I want this Starbase to sponsor this shepherd or these two Starbases, you can go in and override mm-hmm. that. What one of the things we tried to do is make a much more automated, simple system, but not break any of the old mechanics. Let people who like the old mechanics still kind of do what they did. Right. But this way, it's much simpler. And also one of the main reasons why we did it this way is it doesn't break old saves. It doesn't cause it, so you can mm-hmm. load a game from 1.0 into this and it'll still work. So so here's the new shipyard list. This is maybe not the best example here. Let's see, let's find something. Let me actually I know what I can do. I can cancel here. Let me cancel these. Okay, so say I want to build something on this Starbase. I just go here and I say, and I double click on it just like it's a planet. And since I have two things unlocked, I can actually say, and go ahead and order me this one too.
Okay.
So this is now going to send to the Starbase, to its shipyard here, mm-hmm. which is now building this little constructor here. And if I go into here, I can see it says Starbase Factory for HAVO Starbase 1, zero-G scaling for HAVO Starbase 1. And the reason why those were already in the list is because I had built the first or ordered the first one. And we have, by default, originally this wasn't going to be by default, but we all did it all the time. automatically order upgrades. So this is essentially the equivalent to automatic upgrade on a planet where it will automatically build the next factory when it gets unlocked. So as you play, if I keep researching up the industry tree and I end up with a higher level starbase, both of these starbases will order new ones. Now, it only does it to things you've installed. So like, it's not going to order this starbase defense system, but once I install it, then it will order me, as I unlock, it'll actually order me the advanced starbase and et cetera, et cetera. And same with like lasers. It won't install a beam weapon, but it will if you put the beam one on, it'll upgrade it each time.
Awesome.
So this takes away a lot of the starbase micromanagement. Right. The beauty also is the more shipyards you have that are nearby, it knows when it's ordering, it'll go, okay, which shipyard will get it to me fastest? And it orders it to it. It tries to order it that way. That's if you really cancel one and there's already one in the queue here, it will go, oh, okay, I'm the next one ordered, or I'm this for this other starbase. And so it's really, really clever the way it does it. It's one of the reasons why we were able to automate it, is because once Alan got it working, it was much more powerful than we kind of expected. So
go Alan.
It's pretty cool. So that's the new starbase system. I'm going to have to cheat, I guess, because I want.
Oh, Paul.
Well, no, I mean, I want to show more features, and I just started, and I have nothing to show off. All right. So if I go back into here, so this is actually mining, right? So now there is mining is maybe not the best example, but I'm going to go ahead and do this. And perimeter scan, interceptors, whatever, point defense. So now he's just ordered a bunch of stuff. Let me see. So what do I got here? Okay. So this may be a slightly better example. You can see over here now, we actually have this all straight out in the open. You used to have to go into a tab and figure things out. So this actually says, this is giving Earth and Mars 10% of production right now.
Oh man,
when things come over, you'll actually, so you can actually see if there was if it's a military starbase, which let me cheat up.
I'm gonna drop our cameras real quick so people can see what you're indicating.
Our
little squares were kind of blocking some of your.
Let me build up a bunch of more.
There you go. Now you guys can see at the bottom there.
Oh, actually, I wonder what happened. This is not recommended to cheat, because this is, they're all going to fly out. It's going to be a big flood of constructors. All right. Yep. There they all go. Woo. Oh, that's crazy. Yeah. All right.
That's
so,
sort of fun, actually.
So. All right, so here's this.
People are saying that they like the sidebar, so that's great.
Well, okay, so now let me build a military starbase somewhere. I don't care where. I don't have teleporting on, I guess, here. Oh, I'll have to do it the old-fashioned way. Okay, so anyways, as you can see, stop. All right. Command. Oh, I gotta be one more tile over. Okay, command. Oh, I gotta be two more tiles over, and you're gonna be out of range. Get this guy back here.
Guys, if you have any questions for Paul, make sure to tag at Stardock in your comments. It makes it a little easier for me to see it.
Okay, so I'm gonna build this a military ring now. And here's all of the modules. So you can actually see now it's much more easy to tell what you're doing.
Absolutely.
And then I'm going to hit turn here. And now Starbase is still like new modules don't take a plate. Whoa, that was a big sensor boost. Okay, so So now you can see over here, ships and fleets in the area of effect are receiving 25% to tactical speed, beam attack of +1. So now, and also I changed this actually, I think in the last patch, but you're actually getting a +1. You're not getting a 5. So if you have a low ship, you're getting something out of it. And here are the ships that are in my area of effect. Here's the installed modules. If you have, like, if you're playing as Archeans, or if you're doing like an Ascension crystal or something, you might actually end up with two categories in here. So you would have, like, the Archeans will, even on their mining starbase, will have an area where it shows the area, things being affected, and it'll show the ships and stuff. So this is all much more obvious, much more clear. That's very nice. This is all still here. You can order and cancel, and you can still use installed starbases. I mean, installed ships. So you have to be a little careful. If you try and station a constructor at a starbase and then build something, it will consume it, I think. Because I've already ordered it, might not actually, but it will actually consume that module. So you have to be careful with that. Mm-hmm. But the truth is, you'll find yourself very rarely ever doing that. You'll only build constructors really when you want a new constructor, which is, a new starbase or a new shipyard, which is kind of the whole point of this. If you, right now, what the starbases default to ordering a new version of the constructor called the basic constructor, which has no life support or drive or sensors. It's just a module on a stick. So therefore, it's really cheap. And it will always order that. But if you are a power user and you have tons of production and you don't care, you can come in here and toggle through all of your valid constructor designs. So if you have one that's got 5 hyper warps on it because you want to get to the starbase and spend a bunch of money, you can. So that's all still there. I think that covers most of it. Oh, if you want to manually manage the shipyard, you can hit manually manage, and then you can say, no, I only want Seoul Shipyard to be providing me with modules. And that's mostly for long games, like I'm on the other side of the galaxy now. It will be smart enough never to order it from there, in theory, but we give you the option to turn it off. Mm-hmm. Also, if you don't want it to automatically order, you can turn off the automatic order here.
Oh, okay.
All right. Also, this has all been redone, so this is hopefully a little more clear. You can now actually see the starbase's influence, which was sadly missing in the old thing. I think that covers pretty much all of this. The only thing
I love having that there. That's
the only
fantastic
thing that really changed, aside from the ship list, which we'll talk about in a second, here is now it shows how many shipyards are attached.
Oh, awesome.
And also you'll see here it shows like all of these are modules that are ordered.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I might actually, this is a good example of how crazy the ship list used to get. So people who've played the game will know that late game it gets pretty nuts. So this is worst case scenario. This is unlocked, all ships showing. Hey, it looks like one of these is missing a... Oh, this is a custom ship. So I can go up here now, say only show custom ships. Yep, I only have this one custom ship. Mm-hmm. Or I could say only show core ships or computer-generated ships. Or I could say show all ships. So these filters are here. You can also sort by size, attack. I think cost might currently be broken. It might have gotten...
Well, we are in a beta, so...
And then resource... So you can now sort, but what that does is it sorts it inside each of the categories.
That's fantastic.
So these categories are now, rather than doing by hull size, we actually have favored beams, beam ships, missile ships, kinetic ships, balance ships, and specialty ships.
Mm-hmm.
So see, if I go into specialty ships, see it says there are 13 ships in here. You go, wait a second, I only see, and why is, oh, that's a support ship. Why is this in here? Why does it say 7 when I can only see whatever 8?
Right.
So each one of these ships that has multiple marks, so all of the, multiple versions, so all of the dash L, the dash D, the dash P, and now the dash R, are of a ship are now in a subgroup here. So I can actually click this, and you'll see that here's the missile support ships, the beam support ships, and the tactical support ships. And so these are a support ships group.
So it really cleans up the list.
And yeah, and here's a carrier group. Here's a drone carrier and a regular carrier. And where's the assault carrier? Maybe the assault carrier is technically in... Anyways, and then like here's scouts. There's the prototype scout and the regular scout. So I can close this. Now, say it's like, I don't want to have this open. All I ever care about in here is... Now, there's supposed to be some default favored ships, and I think that maybe in the beta it's not working exactly right. But say the transport is supposed to be default favored, so I'm going
to favor
that. And the survey ship, I think, is supposed to be default favored. So now I can go up here, and I can actually, if I don't care, I can close that completely. So here's my survey ship, my colony ship, my constructor, and my transport. Those will stay up there as long as I leave them. And they'll actually... We debated whether to do this, but we actually take them out of the other list so that you don't get confused.
Right.
And now also say I've decided that I'm all beams this game, or I'm all missiles, right? Then I only show the missiles, or I'm using missiles and balanced. And then, but, so you have this sorting. Now, and these right now currently are sorting by size. So I'm going to, I thought that was supposed to toggle. Oh, right now it's just a coincidence that size and cost mean the same thing. So that's why this. Okay, so this these are all flagged right now. Everything that is new, you'll see this says beams, 18 new. We'll have this little icon on it.
Right.
Until you click it. We're going to make that timeout, but currently you have to actually look at it before it goes away. So here's all of the, like, Avatar D, which is the... And these, I tried to make these a little more obvious. This one has the shield leech, which is what makes it the D. This one has the range extender, the beam range extender. This one has the rapid recharger. And this one, which is new, is actually, these are ships that the AI has had for a long time, which I always called prototype because the AI built them. Prototype, which are, these are essentially ships that are designed to take advantage of resources. So if you have a ton of Illyrium, this will build you an avatar with a bunch of special Illyrium-based weapons. And you can see here it's six. Illyrium costs six, so it's locked. Now, in the ship list, obviously everything shows up because you want you to be able to edit it. Now, this same list exists in the shipyard. So we go here. Now, they don't sync because you might want certain things showing here that you don't want showing here. So the favorites sync, but you have to manage these two lists. But they will show the same for all shipyards and the same for the design screen. Awesome. So I can come in here and I can say, I want this cruiser, but I want the... the cruiser R, I don't have the resources for it. Cruiser P, I don't have the resources. And what this will also do is float the highest attack... ship to the top of the group.
Okay.
So if I do have a bunch of Illyrium, the cruiser R will bump up to the top because it's going to have let's see what its attack is. 384. Actually, in this case, because I unlocked, that's not the case. But in most cases, in a normal gameplay, that would be the case. So this all sorts this way, but we collapse them by default. And you can just float. So you really only have to go, what is my most powerful medium ship? It's my Corvette M1.
Right.
And in this case, my cruiser, it's my most powerful large medium ship or large beam ship. And so, but all of these show here. And you can also, now let's go down. I think that one support ship was a really good example. Okay, so here's this beam support ship down here. So let's go back to the design screens where things aren't grayed out. Okay, so I want to go. Did that expand when I did the other one? It's because this is expanding. All right, so I'm going to go to the specialty ships. You can see here in the beam support, see all these icons. So you can actually see this has the beam attack. This is it's got a field generator. It's got a field augment array. It's got a leeching field. It's got a shield leech. So each of these We try and show like the things that make the ship different. We don't show all the stats here. Like this has the survey here because it can survey. This has the invade because it can invade. Mm-hmm. We show the, if it's an armed ship, we show its primary attack and its primary defense. And like this cutter, this little custom cutter somebody made has nothing, so it just shows the beam. Now, say I design a new ship. Let's go in and design us something cool. Hey, that's nice. This is somebody downloaded.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so I'm going to give it a stellar folding drive. Oh. Oh, he animated that Bob. That's funny.
Really?
Yeah, so that's why that's... That must have been a pain in the butt. Okay, so I'm gonna give it a prototype hyperdrive, and I'm gonna give it some special support modules, and give it a rapid recharger, energy accelerator, and a launch assist. I don't know what any of those are. Slingshot booster. So now it's got a bunch of special features on here, and I'm gonna save this as surveil. I don't know why it's called that. So here's my new ship that I just built, and you can see here it says, you can see that the rapid recharger is here. So you can actually really quickly see what makes a ship special.
That's fantastic.
So that should be very helpful. Also, it's a little subtle. They're smaller than I would like, but there are little icons here now that represent the ship's class. So this is a colony ship. This is a constructor.
Oh, that's
this
fantastic.
This is a transport. And those are the tactical icon you see on the map. So you can now go, oh, when I see that, it means this type of ship.
That's fabulous.
So those are all, that's the ship list.
All right.
You can favor and unfavor things. I say it's late game. I don't care about surveys anymore. I can do this. Now, the favorite list does last from game to game. So if you unfavor colony ship the next game, it won't be there. We were debating whether to have it reset each time, but we're going to trust that the players know what they want.
Yeah.
Also, like late game, maybe you just hide the whole favorite list, or your favorite list is all you want. Now, it will also work per race, so it's not going to, like if you favor, actually, I don't know if that's exactly. Anyways, it should remember per race, per game, so it'll be different for each race. Mm-hmm. We have any questions?
We do. Let me scroll up a bit. They asked a few while you were talking. Let's see. Lots of people who are excited about the list and excited about the update. So, let's see. If one starbase is 50 tiles away from the nearest shipyard and another starbase is 5 tiles away, will they both order a high-range expensive constructor?
No. Well, yes, if you set it to be a high-range expensive constructor.
Gotcha.
That's why we let it by default. Now, the good news is if you have multiple shipyards, the star bases will be smart enough not to order it for the one that's super far away if there's one closer.
Okay.
Now, that said, like you said, you can manually manage it. So say let me rephrase. I guess I maybe lied. You can set the constructor per star base.
Okay.
So you could go in and say on the far away one, oh, this is what happens when you unlock and then...
Oh, neat.
So you instantly win. Okay. So let me go back to...
Paul accidentally the whole thing, so... Yes.
So, sorry. I guess I mislead. I was wrong. So all star bases can have their own... ship that they order. So if you have one that's really close, you have your planets around your thing, you can leave them all defaulting to basic constructor and they'll crank those out pretty fast. Okay. If you have somebody that's far away, but you know that star base, even though it's far away, that's my main manufacturing plant, it's going to kick these things out really fast, you can set it to use a super expensive one with long range. Well, not, you don't really need range if you're sending it to a star base, but with super fast drives. And then even if you can even go so far as to manually manage the things and say, always order them from there and order me the super expensive one.
Right.
Or the super fast one. So yes, you will have that option.
Okay. Excellent. Let's see. We've also got if a ship is moving somewhere that's going to take many turns to get there, can we have a setting where it will stop moving if it comes in range of something that will attack it? For example, colony or constructors going out into the night, stopping when they run into a pirate.
A little bit. What I would like to do is make it so they alert you that there's somebody near if you have
that would be good.
Problem like that. We got to. It's kind of a fine line to walk between, you know, playing the game for the player. But yes, mm-hmm. we can definitely do something a little better for that.
Right.
There's a bunch of little automation things we want to do like that. I don't. Not like this. There you go. Example. Oops. Scout should have not gone by the pirate.
Story of my life yeah, right there.
Yeah. So, you know, we want to do a bunch of little things like that. I'd like a patrol function because the AI has a patrol function mm-hmm. and the player doesn't have that. A couple of things like that that we'd like to do. I'd like to rework guard and sentry to make a little more sense. We have lots of tasks we're finally finding some time to get to now that we're pretty happy with things. The next bunch of patches, this isn't really related to the question, but this, what you're seeing here was originally what 1.7 was going to be. But we had talked about a couple more things. Mm-hmm. So that's why this is an opt-in. So this is like half. The second half is all going to be much more subtle stuff. We're going to do a bunch of fixes to diplomacy mm-hmm. and mostly addressing a lot of like weaknesses in the AI where he falls for mm-hmm. cheese tactics. So we're going to spend some time with that. So when this actually does come out sometime, probably actually after April when we go to the full build, we'll probably have another beta of this, of 1.7, that has a bunch of diplomacy changes.
Right.
As well as, and this is going to start, well, I don't know, maybe it's been long enough where people are going to, we're going to change the way sensors work.
Oh, really?
Which was a hotly debated, I don't know, you weren't really here, but a hotly debated war on the forums. What I decided would be the easiest thing to do, because people want to be able to build big sensor boats, and we want mm-hmm. them to be able to build big sensor boats. But we also don't want the cheese of first turn you can build something that unveils the whole galaxy to you. So what we're doing is making sensors volumetric instead of linear. So when you add sensor points on, you're actually going to be expanding almost like influence. You're doing it on a sphere. So now we have a new stat called sensor power that all the sensors will contribute to. And the higher your sensor, the power, the further your range. So you can still build a sensor boat and put a zillion on it. We're not going to stop you from doing that. But it will also be a lot harder to do these crazy, crazy ranged things. So it's almost like doing diminishing returns like by some arbitrary rule. But instead, we just switched it to be a actual just like, all right, now you're scanning the volume instead of scanning straight out. And it makes sense. It's like if I have a flashlight that can go 100 feet, the same power of that flashlight, if it was distributed over, you know, a sphere of 10 feet might be all you get. So so that's kind of the math behind that. And I'm still testing it and balancing it. So far it's working out really well, I think. Though I know a few people are probably going to yell at me for it.
You know, I feel like we're going to get yelled at, you know.
Well, somebody, yeah. There's always going to be a dissenting opinion somewhere, yeah. I think once people play with it, they'll realize that it is
overall,
it is better.
The goal is
it's overall makes the game more fun.
It's to improve playability. And
same with diplomacy things. Like, when we fix these diplomacy things, we'll get yelled at because there are certain exploits that people have been using to win the game.
Right.
Which is great. I mean, we actually love it when people are like, hey, here's my detailed list of how I win the game in 37 turns.
Oh,
we like those. Well, we have a guy, and I doubt if he's listening, but I'm sure he's on the forums, who sent in something and said, here's how to win on a large galaxy with, and it's a diplomacy hack.
Really?
In that it's just literally like if you do a custom race with these things and you aren't nearby anybody and you really quickly meet them all and you well the diplomacy, right, you can get an alliance really fast, and then once you have an alliance you can get a Or you can get an expiration treaty. Once you have an expiration treaty, you can get an alliance, and then you can win through an alliance war. And it, I mean, alliance victory. It's really crazy, and it's silly things like, why on earth would they trust you, ally to you in five turns? And it's literally because when we're designing the game, we're like, well, nobody's going to be able to do that that quickly, so we don't build in like a timer for it.
Right.
So what we're going to do is make it so that some treaties and stuff are a little more expensive, are pushed back. We're going to make all trade values more weighted by game difficulty and by their relations with you. Mm-hmm. So, like, if somebody hates you, even if you offer them a planet, they're going to think it's worth garbage. So you're right. We'll have a much more realistic curve. I mean, no other game in the world goes, yeah, I hate you, but that's a fair market value. So we're working on that. We're also going to make it so... So certain treaties, which is what I started with, have a timer. So it's like, I will not even consider having a treaty with you until we've had good relations for X number of turns.
Right.
So as right now, it's like, oh, we have X number. I mean, on turn one, if for some reason I like you enough, I will give you a treaty right now, mm-hmm. which is ridiculous because they just met you.
Right.
So silly things like that.
I just met you and this is crazy.
Silly exploits, yes. It's like a
here's my
it's
treaty,
like a
so
romantic
call me
comedy where it's, oh, we were stuck on this bus. Going 55 miles an hour. And
strangers
now we're
on a
allies.
Train.
Yeah, so...
let's bring Hemingway into it.
So we... That is a lot of little things like that. We're also doing some mass adjustments and things like that just to, mm-hmm. to overall make the game a little more reliable. I think that the most... the biggest improvement in 1.7 Part 2 will probably all be the diplomacy stuff, which of course is... subtle and hard to show off, but I think people will like it.
Awesome.
And we could probably go back to some questions now that I rambled on.
No, you're fine. We do have a few. Let's see. Some people asking for things like a pop-up on the load ship screen to display load colony ship or load transport, maybe even have an indicator on the map of where you are.
It doesn't say load.
Or a mini map in the Starbase screen or planet screen telling us where we are when we are upgrading it.
On the Starbase?
I think that's what he's asking.
You don't? Well, I can kind of see that. Let's see. So here, I'm on here. I don't know where this Starbase is, I guess. I mean, it does say the planet. That's maybe something to consider. It's hard to... throw the mini map around because it's even with the mini map sometimes, like especially on a large galaxy, it almost means nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll have to think about that.
Alrighty, let's see. And then will the AI ever upgrade their survey ships?
The truth is, if the AI doesn't see anything good around, it won't bother. So yes, but it should. And matter of fact, I'm working on some stuff, and it probably won't even be until Crusade, but where we're going to make just the AI a little smarter with those, especially so it can go get things like this. Whereas right now it can, but half the time it dies. And also, the AI does tend to really like to buy mercenary survey ships. So it will often use those instead of building new ones.
Awesome. Will you be able to shift or control click ships to mass, obsolete, or favorite?
You know, not right now, but that's not a bad idea. I would more of the mass, obsolete, and would be useful. I doubt if anybody's going to want a mass favor because then your list would just become a big mess, which is what we already had. So... also, hopefully you will find that you don't need to mass obsolete things anymore, that if all goes well. So that's our goal. Mm. Also, like if you're a hardcore player and you only use your own ships, you can now just do this and you'll only see your own ships. So you don't have to worry about
it. Awesome.
We did run into a problem the other day, and I never would have thought this would happen, but our producer actually obsoleted all of the core ships.
What?
And he's like, well, how do I un-obsolete? And we're like, well, you don't. So we're considering making a checkbox that restores them, but it's a little more complicated than it sounds.
So Patrick broke it.
Yeah, Patrick. But and he's like, "Well, I'm locked." I'm like, "No, you're not. You just go design your own damn ship." He's like, "Oh yeah," but no. Yeah, it is a thing that a new player could accidentally do. So we do.
That sounds like something that I would do, to be perfectly honest with you.
Well, I mean, do you go, "Hey, what's this obsolete? Oh, ship disappeared. Oh, you know, you." I mean, I would actually, I almost wish we could just have a control, an obsolete or something like that. Mm-hmm. But that's kind of a mechanic that we don't use anywhere else, so nobody would know it was there.
Right.
So. Oh, apparently
excuse me.
While I was away, a war started.
Still getting over this bronchitis. Zapgun for Hire says, speaking of diplomacy, can we perhaps have some diplomatic penalties or bonuses for factions that are historically friendly or... enemies toward each other, like the Taurians and Drengen or the Terrans and the Archeans.
You know, honestly, there are already, but they're hard-coded. And yes, we can, and we're going to do that. But,
cool.
But we're going to make it smarter. That's one of the things we're working on. But no. As a matter of fact, for the next patch, not 1.7, which is still like a month out, the full version, we are going to, or at least the current plan, is to have a... new system or the ability to download whole factions and ship styles from Steam. So like people who make these, like Omnibus makes, you know, zillion ships. You could package those all up as a style and you could make a new faction.
Right.
And right now what I'm working on is part of reason why this brings up is I'm working on it won't be an in-game editor, but an editor that will let players make the flavor text, make things like that, and we'll be able to have some modifiers and stuff that you will be able to build in. So if you make your Klingons and your Romulans, and you can make it so that the Klingons and Romulans respond to each other appropriately and have the right text and hate each other automatically or whatever.
Right.
So that's one of the things we're working on. It's not done or anywhere near done. It's kind of like a side project at this point for me. That's the current plan for, I guess it would be 1.8.
Excellent. Let's see. We've also got, can there be a way to create custom tabs in the design menu?
Oh, like these? No, not yet.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just really happy to have this.
No, that really is fantastic. I'm excited to play with it.
Currently, you cannot do is you can't make custom groups.
Okay.
And I know that people are going to ask for that immediately. Mm-hmm. So we're going to work on that, but it probably won't get in until 1.8 or even.
Gotcha.
And let's see how people use them. You know, I mostly wanted it because we've got all of these optional designs, and all they did was flood the list, and the response as a modern designer is, well, take out the ones that aren't important. And I'm like, but this in Galciv, there's nuance, and you want the ability to, you know, what if you have Illyrium, or what if you have this? So this was my answer to that, and hopefully people will like it.
And then, will an AI fleet ever get to attack more than once per turn?
You know, that is something we were just talking about
in
the meeting yesterday. And the answer is eventually, yes. There is it's a multiplayer problem that causes it to happen. It gets nasty with the multiplayer because of multiplayer. And it wouldn't be hard to make them attack as many turns as they have.
Mm-hmm.
But as a rule, we try and make it so the AI doesn't have a bunch of turns when he gets there and he doesn't waste his attacks. I said if it does happen, we'd like them to be able to do that. And currently you cannot. I mean, it does not. And like I said, it all comes from a multiplayer issue, multiplayer stability. Ooh.
Oh.
Apparently, the Taurians and the Iridium are having a slapdown.
Hello.
So, yes, we're working on that, but it's not on the books for, not on the official task list, but it is something we're actively looking into.
Okay, excellent. And Silior says, I know 1.7 is just coming out, however, can you talk a little bit about the future of Gal Civ 3 and where it's headed for with DLCs and things prior to the Expandalone next year?
Okay, well...
I don't know how much we can say,
the
guys,
Expandalone is still debatably Expandalone. I really am pro Expandalone. It's kind of a Steam debate right about how Steam works right now. But the expansion, whether it's Expandalone or whether it's... we do it the way we did Mercenaries is still, it doesn't really matter. The main thing with Crusade is we're going to do a much bigger overhaul. I'm kind of in my brain thinking of it as Gal 3.5. How big that overhaul is going to be is still up in the air, depending on what Brad wants to green light.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a lot of ideas, a lot of things that I'm already prototyping and testing.
Right.
That really depends on that. There's going to be a lot of new things. We're going to probably completely rework the resource system. We're going to probably rework the way range and some of the battle mechanics work. I personally would like to rework the battles. That's just a little more expensive of a prospect that I don't know if I'm going to be able to get to do. I want to have a really big campaign with a lot more triggers.
Right.
If at all possible in Crusade, I'd like to make it possible for players to make campaigns, at least modders too.
Yeah.
They already can, but it's pretty complicated. And I've developed enough of these silly editor tools to make it easy for me that I think with a little bit of extra work, I could probably make it something we could distribute to players and they could make their own campaigns, which then we could put on Steam, and that would be awesome.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's see, what else? We're going to bring in currently on the books, and I don't think any of this is secret, but you know, who cares? we're going to do units, so there'll be units and like spies and...
Oh, neat.
And commanders. The commanders I always wanted to do are currently in design. Hopefully I will actually get to do them. I think the Taurians are going to die. It looks like the Iridium are kind of flooding.
They've had a rough life, Paul. You just...
Look at all these. They built like 1,000 transports and then immediately retreat because it's too dangerous over there to use them.
It's like, nope, I am going to nope out of this.
And he's like, I built this. Oh, you're dead.
No,
I guess we should see who else is dying out here in the world. There's mercenary flying around. So there's the Terrans. Who are the Terrans at war with? Let's take a look. See. Oh, there's actually only two wars going on. We're supposed to fix this, dang it. Oh, wait, no, I guess they're not at war. Oh, I see. I don't have... Hey, wasn't show all on? Okay, that might be a bug. Anyways, so we have a bunch of things like that. The big thing, probably the biggest push of the next of Crusade will be a beefier campaign, because it's actually going to go back into the lore. We're going to have the Crusade part of Crusade. But the biggest gameplay dynamics, aside from reworking resources, will be just assorted units. So like the commanders will be a thing, citizens and a bunch of assorted things like that, where you'll be able to train people on your planets and then place them on a tile to get bonuses.
Right.
You'll also be able to and we're going to completely rework Invasion. I mean, completely. Okay. Like, completely, completely.
Do we have any big plans between now and Crusades for Galaxy?
There's going to be tons of little stuff. The next DLC is still kind of up in the air. We're working on... It's probably going to be ship-themed. Like, we've got a we've got a guy who's been working on nothing but all these parts that people have requested.
Oh, wow.
And a bunch of fun stuff like that. But that's more cosmetic. We're trying to come up with but it will probably be tied to the players being able to share factions.
Right.
That's what the next one will be. And then who knows what's after that. I mean, we have lists and ideas and ideas. But all just comes down to, a lot of it comes back to player feedback. If we do something and everybody goes, oh, I want more of this, then we, you know, we do that. This is a big ass war going on over here.
Yikes.
Where are they all going?
They're
all going
to
the shipyard. That seems weird.
That scares me a little bit.
This must be their rally point to go somewhere else. Oh, yep, they're going here, and now they're all heading off. Oh, see, they're coming here, building big-ass fleets of 10 units. Yep. And then they're all flying off to attack the Terrans.
Alrighty, let's see. Somebody mentioned that the game keeps crashing when they try to make a new game on the insane map. I would recommend submitting a support ticket if you have not. I don't know if you have any further advice on dealing with
that. Well, the insane maps, depending on your system, can be problematic. I would consider putting less players on it, or lowering the planet or the star density. Just essentially get it to be a little less intense. It's really not so much the size of the map as the number of players. So once you get a ton of players on there, it starts using a lot of memory. And if your system isn't really got a ton of memory, it will start causing lag. And also even your video card, because now you've got a bazillion ships out there, even if they're in the fog or whatever.
Right.
We're always trying to optimize the insane map, but it's called insane for a reason, unfortunately. It was insane of us to do it. But it's enough people do enjoy it to where we're really happy we did, but it has caused a lot of problems because it's just so damn big.
Right.
I would have been happy with only twice as large as the biggest map in Galsif 2. But instead we did four times, so.
Well, apparently something else everybody enjoys are the supermassive black holes. Zapgun for Hire is asking if they can have a map setting where there's always one of those on the map.
honestly, that was originally the plan.
Oh, really?
Was all galaxies were to have one in it, and it kind of broke some of the things. So I only really ever use them in placed maps. Mm-hmm. But yes, we'll be reworking some of the.
They're so pretty.
Some reworking some of the map generation. So here's another little thing that you didn't really see with my. Oh wait, no, that's a mining star base. So this mining star base is attached to this shipyard, and this shipyard, and this shipyard. So you can actually see every one, two, three. You can see. So he's ordering from all of those locations, and it only shows up. Those lines only show up when you select it, because, like I said, in a late game, you could actually have 50 star shipyards sponsoring star base, and therefore we get like this one here. Look at that. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shipyards all sending out constructors the same place.
All right. Reset. No. All right. Keep your questions coming, guys. I'm trying to see all of them as best I can. are there filters, or are there going to be filters for the shipyard quick build menu?
Shipyard quick build menu.
Yes. Zingo7 says that forgot to do filters for shipyard quick build menu. Still a mess here once more designs are unlocked.
Yard quick build menu.
Not sure what you
mean. Oh!
Paul knows what you mean.
That's sad, because the truth is I never used the quick build menu, so I kind of forgot all about it. This menu.
Okay.
You know what? I'm going to see how hard it would be just to rework the screen to put the other list in it.
Right, yeah.
I
actually
this.
Didn't even know I that there was a quick build
this.
Menu.
What's
I've
funny,
never
in
Galsif, used it either.
Galsif 2, I used this constantly.
But never now?
But in Galsif 3, I'm for some reason, I just am much more prone to go in here because I want to see more details. I want to see my ships. But you know, we did design this in as modular a way as possible. So I will look into seeing to hook it in there. What I really would like to avoid is essentially doing like another version of the same list. So what we can do is, what I might even do is make the quick build list like wider and have the list be here, or figure out some way to make it a little more robust. Yeah, that's funny. I forgot all about this. That's embarrassing as the lead designer of the game that I forgot this screen existed. Yeah, that needs some love. So, yes. No, awesome. There were no current plans to do that, but now there are.
Now, are
so
there any...
you go. Answer.
Are there any possible plans for decluttering options on the main map? So things like hiding or fading out nebulas or asteroids so you can easily distinguish planets and ships, star bases, resources?
Yes and no. It's... Yes, there are options. There are ideas about that, but nothing currently on the schedule.
Gotcha. Wow, awesome.
They're like a, looks like it's going to come down to the Iridium and the Drengen.
It's been requested that I point and laugh at you. I don't know why.
Look at that. They've hit the...
Ooh.
This is actually crazy. It's nice to see the Iridium holding their own. What is...
And of course the Drengen are old buddies.
And the Torians. Oh, that's me. Never mind. Yeah. Wow.
Man.
Whoa. We should probably fix that to where it doesn't floor all the way down if they hit zero. So these I'm assuming these people are dead.
Right.
Yeah. That's kind of throws off the chart.
See, I'm not sure if you mentioned this already, Paul. We talked about constructors a bit back, but somebody mentioned that they reset back to basic design when the new tech for them is unlocked.
Is that you mean the one on the shipyard? On the starbase?
Sounds like they're asking,
so
yes.
So all of them are resetting back to basic design?
Could you clarify on that, Zingo7,
yeah.
For us?
That shouldn't happen. That would be a bug. So that would please report that. So let me actually set this to the Hermit Crab M4. And then we'll soak for a little while longer. Although, here, let me actually go find a tech that I know will cause a new constructor to be built.
Zingo 7 says yes, so it must be what you were
mentioning. Okay, yeah, no, that is a bug. Actually... the reason why I probably didn't catch that is because I don't ever change them. Because I find that the small one is fine.
Gotcha.
So let's see. What do we got here? Hyperwarp. Let's go.
And will we be adding any more commands to the govern panel?
Yes, but probably not in this patch, or maybe, but for sure later. Mm-hmm. We have, I want to rework the govern screen pretty much entirely. I want to rework this. I want to rework this. But the changes I have maybe are a little too beefy for a patch, so they might not end up until Crusade or until whatever, like, middle of the year DLC we do. Or, you know, I mean, they'd, of course, changes like that will be, not be DLC, but will come with, like, some larger DLC.
Right.
Somehow this guy has got a bunch of, he must have built a bunch of ships with. You know, this is still breaking every once in a while. We can fix this 1,000 times.
Oh, no.
Damn it. I wonder if it only happens when I'm soaking. That's why I only see it when I'm here. Anyways, I will look into the constructor thing. It's not supposed to do that.
Yeah, he clarifies by saying if you enable the latest design when you unlock a new tech, they reset back to basic crappy ones.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, we'll have to make sure that it does not happen.
And then Eviator asks, can we change focuses on the colonies tab or planet list yet?
Not yet, but that is one of the things we're working on.
Excellent.
We'll have it here. What's funny is actually what we can probably do. You know what? We might. I don't know if we'll get it into the next patch, but I might do kind of a hacky version like we had in Gals of 2 where these act as a button.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can boom, boom, boom. What I want to do is a better list.
Right.
But, you know, since time is money, maybe we can do what we did before.
Right.
And I don't think it would be terribly hard.
Craig 4140 asks, if my starbase is set to order constructors with 4 modules, will it order a constructor every upgrade or only every 4 upgrades?
It will, depending on the pace in which you're ordering them, right? So if you unlocked the game, or if you build a starbase late game and you have like 30 modules available, it will order. I think it's smart enough to know, oh, I'm going to get 4 with this constructor if you have it set to that.
Mm-hmm.
However, if you are ordering only 1 and you have it set to 4, it will order all 4. It'll order it, and then it'll sit there with 3 points until you add new modules.
Gotcha.
Now, and say you've run out of modules to build, it'll just sit there with those three constructors in orbit until it has something to build. You can eject them, actually, and then send them off to build somewhere else if you want.
Okay.
You know, this is a beta, so
mm-hmm.
let us know if that, how this is why we have it out. We have a beta and not just releasing
it. Yeah, please join us on our forums if you haven't. Yeah. Let us know what you find.
We need to know how this new system is going to work absolutely. For people. I'm pretty happy with it. It's not absolutely perfect, but it's as, because I mean, I really would like to redo the system entirely,
mm-hmm.
But that's going to have to wait till something else. But I think this is a really good enhancement of what we had, and it still
right.
has kind of the same feeling as Scalsiv 2 or as this, where you still have the constructors mm-hmm. and we're not. I mean, this very conversation is kind of a reason why we kept it. It's because people want to be able to go, oh, I made this fast constructor
right.
that gets that there. If we had changed it to a system where it was like, no, your shipyard just sends 50 points, and then once 50 points gets there, the module builds.
Right.
It would be a whole different thing, a whole different mechanic. So I'm pretty happy with how it came out. So, but we need feedback. We need people to tell us.
I'm absolutely
about to die. We're back to like this little corner.
And on similar note of discussing Galsiv 2, Zabgun for Hire says, list of uninhabited planets, list of planets owned by other factions, please. Which apparently was a Galsiv 2 thing.
Yeah, that was a Galsiv 2 thing. I'm fine. I think the problem was in the Galsiv 2. I don't know. Yeah, no, it's on our list of things. The only real debatable question is where to put it, whether we'd put
right.
it over here in the colonies.
Oh, that was an explosion.
Or whether it would have to be like its own thing or be in some like a sub tab
right.
of the governor thing. Or its own screen entirely. These are all questions that
mm-hmm.
that we'd have to play with. Whoa, big
ships. Is auto-colonization something that's a consideration or a possibility?
What would auto-colonization be?
Not sure.
I build
sure
a colony ship and it goes out and looks for a colony?
Maybe.
That seems like we're going a little too far into the I play the game mm-hmm. for you mode. Or even like, I mean, it would be almost like auto-constructors.
Right.
We don't want you to have to micromanage constructors, but we want you to pick where you're putting.
Right, of course, yes.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's see. You have any parting words in regards to 1.7 beta?
Go get it. Let us know
check
what you
out.
Think. There is some tweaks to mass already in this build.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are a hardcore player and you have a bunch of custom ships that you have designed that are suddenly no longer showing up, go into, hopefully this won't happen very often. But like I said, if you had like a super fine-tuned end game ship and you get to the end game and your ship never showed up, it's probably because now the mass is now illegal.
Right.
We don't want you to lose your ships. So you can go into gameplay here and say, show over capacity designs. And all of your designs will show up here. They'll be grayed out or red. Mm-hmm. And then you can use the design and then take off whatever components you need to make them legal again.
Awesome.
So that's the only warning. I was really dubious. We even toyed with the idea of letting people use illegal ships that are old. But the problem with that would be people would feel obligated to keep their their cheese ships forever. So if you run into that problem, it's easily fixed. You just go in there and you open the ship and you tweak it. Mm-hmm. So that's the only kind of gotcha I'm a little bit worried about. Everything else I'm very happy with. I think people are going to like it a lot better. I'm sure that there's a lot of people who will still want more. And we have more.
Always going to have more.
We have more we want to do. Yes. So it's just a matter of how much time are we going to get to spend, and now I'm dead. So that's maybe appropriate time. All right.
All right. And on that note, everybody, thank you for joining us for the stream today. Next week, there will be a stream for Ashes of the Singularity since we are releasing on Thursday, the 31st, and Brad Wardell will be joining me here. So those are always pretty entertaining. You might not want to miss that
one. And if you haven't tried Ashes and if you like RTSs, you should go try
it. It really is a lot of fun. We've been playing a lot of it. We have devs versus fans tomorrow from 4 p.m. Eastern all the way to 6 p.m. Eastern. So you can hop on into a game with some of the members of Stardock here. But at any rate, join us. Well, as soon as we have a date for the next Galsiv stream, you will be informed. So,
and we're
and this will be up on YouTube later. So
Ashes is coming along really good. It's a really fun game. If you like if you like RTSs, give it a try.
Absolutely. So thank you guys for your support, and we look forward to seeing you. For those of you who celebrate the holidays, have a lovely long weekend.
Bye-bye.
Bye.